Right now, Paul Manafort, Donald Trump's former campaign chairman, is in a federal courtroom pleading guilty to 2 counts of conspiracy. In return, he will avoid the trial. Yes, this is his second trial that was due to start Monday, less than a month after his first trial ended with him being convicted on 8 counts. So what is happening in court right now? What does this deal mean? Does this deal now mean that he is cooperating in some way, shape, or form with Robert Mueller's team? Let's find out. CNN's Shimon Prokipes is following all of these developments at this moment. Shimon, what's happening right now?
Major development here, Kate. We're learning just moments ago that Paul Manafort has agreed to cooperate with Justice Department. He is the prosecutor there, Andrew Weissman, told a judge moments ago in court that his plea agreement, Paul Manafort's plea agreement, is a cooperation agreement, and the other charges they will drop at the sentencing or at the agreement of successful cooperation. So here, Kate, obviously a stunning development. This is the answer that we've been looking for to a question of whether or not this agreement, whether or not this plea would mean Paul Manafort would cooperate. And here we have it just moments ago. Obviously, what that agreement entails, we don't know. The government did tell the judge that Paul Manafort proffered. He gave information to the government already. We believe that that had occurred in the last few days. So certainly a major development here in this investigation, Kate. We now have word from the court, from the government, that Paul Manafort is cooperating in this investigation.
This is huge news, and this has been the major question all along, Shimon, right? If there was a plea deal, what was the, if it came before the first trial or after the first trial, before the second trial, this, say it one more time. Evan Perez, Shimon, hold on 1 second. I'm going to go to Evan Perez. He's outside the courtroom. Let's go to Evan right now. Evan, you were inside. What can you tell us about what's happening right now?
That's right, Kate. Just a minute ago, prosecutor Andrew Weissman announced in court that there is a cooperation agreement with Paul Manafort. Now, we don't know the details yet of what exactly that cooperation agreement is, what the terms of it is, but he did mention it just as he was explaining what Paul Manafort is pleading guilty to. Now, that's a bit of a surprise because it was a big question, obviously, that everybody had as a result of this plea agreement was whether or not there was an ongoing cooperation agreement. And it appears from what we've just learned that there is a cooperation agreement. Now, what this entails is obviously the big question now. We had talked to President Trump's legal team in the last couple of days as these talks had intensified, and they expressed confidence that if there was a cooperation agreement, they were confident that this did not involve any cooperation against the president. So there are other people, obviously, that are part of this investigation. We know that there are people who are charged, including people in Russia who are charged in the special counsel investigation. So it may well be that Paul Manafort is going to provide information about those people who he was in business with over the last few years, obviously. So again, a lot of details yet to come out, but this was a bit of a surprise in court. I can describe to you right now a little bit of the scene. Paul Manafort is standing there in a dark gray suit with a purple tie, and he's very glum. We've seen him smiling a lot in court, especially over in Virginia where he was on trial. Today he's not smiling at all. He's glum, and he's quietly responding, "Yes, Your Honor," when the judge is explaining to him all of the rights that he's giving up as a result of this plea deal. As a result of this plea deal, Kate, one of the things he's doing is he's giving up his right to any appeal, and the government is agreeing to drop the remaining 10 charges that he faces in Virginia. So this is going to resolve the charges that he's facing in Virginia as well as here in the District of Columbia. One other interesting thing that was mentioned by the judge is that Paul Manafort is giving up the rights to his story. Essentially, he's giving up the right to make any money off of publishing any book or any movies that might be made from this entire saga.
Far before then, we've got a lot more questions right now. Evan, hold on 1 second. Let me get back over to Shimon. Shimon, there's a big question right now is why didn't he do this sooner? Do you know why?
Right. We don't know. That is an excellent question. He could have done this sooner, could have avoided the trial. Again, we don't know everything about this cooperation, and we will probably learn sometime soon what it will involve. But, you know, think about this, Kate. You now have a key figure in this entire investigation, Paul Manafort, who's met with the special counsel, has offered information to the special counsel. We don't know what that information is. This is something that we have all along have been saying that the special counsel wanted. They wanted his cooperation. Now, it could be that his cooperation is limited only to certain things. Obviously, the big question is does that involve anything with the president or the campaign, or does this involve other things? Hopefully, those questions will be answered. But this is certainly, and you know, something that will change the impact. This will impact the investigation. This will change the way this investigation goes. I had never expected, certainly, that Paul Manafort would sit with the special counsel, sit with them for interviews, tell them things he knows, tell them crimes that he's committed, perhaps crimes that he knows of that other people have committed. No doubt, the fact that the special counsel here has met with him, that they did this proffer agreement, that he's now entered into this cooperation agreement, changes the entire dynamic of this investigation and really this story as we move forward, Kate.
Yeah, I mean, this has been a huge question from the very beginning when there was an investigation into Paul Manafort. And now we've got this absolutely has to change the dynamic of this entire thing. Joining me right now, joining all of us right now, is going to be CNN legal analyst Shan Wu, defense attorney and former federal prosecutor. For a time, he served as an attorney for Rick Gates, the star witness in the first trial of Paul Manafort. And CNN chief legal analyst Jeffrey Toobin is here. Jeffrey, does this surprise you?
Well, I mean, what surprises me is that he didn't do it earlier if he was going to do it. I mean, all of the benefit you get from cooperating is you don't force the government to go to trial. You get the benefit in sentencing of cooperation. He will get some benefit in sentencing from cooperation, but it certainly wasn't advantageous of him to go to trial
and
then
cooperate. So this is confusing a little bit in part?
It is. I mean, you know, criminal defendants don't always act very rationally. They sometimes are angry, they're nervous, they think they can beat a case. He obviously didn't beat this case. But the real question now is, and the question that consumes the whole matter is, what is he telling Mueller's office? What does he know about other people's criminality? And what does he know about any illegality in particular regarding the Trump campaign in 2016.
Shan, what do you think, and this is an unknown, but what's the universe of possibility of what the terms of this cooperation agreement could be?
Oh, I think we can discern that without it being in writing. It's a little bit unusual. It was not reduced to writing, actually. If I were his counsel, I would have wanted that guarantee in writing. But the universe is a very broad one for the benefits to Manafort. I mean, if his cooperation is helpful, his sentence could be vastly reduced through a number of mechanisms. They can file a letter asking the judge to go beneath the guidelines. They can do what's called a Rule 35, asking for the sentence to be reduced later. I agree completely with Jeffrey.
Kind of jail time was he looking at?
Well, if you're looking at the Virginia one alone at this point, it looks like under the guidelines, that's probably going to be around 10 years. The D.C. one could have been much higher when you put on top of that, but I understand that part of this deal was they capped it at 10 years, and I would expect that his defense team is looking for it to be substantially less than that in light of the cooperation. And, you know, to Jeffrey's point, it's surprising he didn't do it earlier. It definitely would have been advantageous for him to do it earlier, but, you know, they go through, people in this situation go through a very slow change in their attitude. They start off very angry, often in denial. His team clearly was willing to fight very, very hard. They took a gamble splitting it into two cases, and mm-hmm. that began to unravel early. And this is a huge victory for the Mueller prosecution. They just put huge pressure on Manafort, tying up all his assets in the bail negotiations. Most of those are going to be forfeited now. They flipped his business partner, Gates. So it's just been a march of going forward with tremendous pressure, and now they've basically caused him to cave.
And part of the plea agreement is he admits to absolutely everything that he was charged with.
And everything that he fought in the last trial.
Everything he fought in the last trial. The outstanding
on
charges.
On the most simple level, Jeffrey, he has to provide the government, the Mueller team needs to get something out of this cooperation. They wouldn't agree to this deal unless they were going to get something significant out of it.
Correct. I mean, that's true. I mean, they didn't really give up very much here. Since he's admitted to everything, a 10-year cap, I mean, he probably wasn't going to get more than 10 years anyway. So the way federal sentencing works is if it's done, criminal sentences, you have to serve 85% of a sentence that you get in federal court mm-hmm. today. If he got 10 years, he was looking at 8.5 years in prison. He's 69 years old. 8.5 years at 69 is a very, very long sentence. If you cooperate and the prosecution agrees that your cooperation is significant, they can go to the judge and reduce your sentence. But dramatically, the judges in federal court reward cooperation a great deal, but prosecutors have to be impressed by this cooperation. They have to believe that you are telling the truth. Presumably, there have been discussions here. I mean, you have what's called proffer sessions where prosecutors get a good sense of what you're saying.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
They already know what he's going to say.
Okay.
And they obviously think it's worthwhile making this deal.
Let me bring in right now CNN's chief political analyst, Gloria Borger. Gloria, as Shimon says, this is a huge moment in changing the narrative and changing the dynamic of this entire story regarding Robert Mueller's investigation into possible collusion and obstruction of justice that leads up to the president.
Right. Well, we don't know when, and I think Shimon was saying this, and Jeff, we don't really know at this point what cooperation will mean in this particular case. And I just got off the phone with a source who's familiar with the Manafort case and is a pro-Trump source. And, you know, this source says that all along Manafort's attorneys had been telling the president's lawyers that he had nothing to say about Donald Trump. And we just saw that Sarah Sanders just tweeted
She just put out a statement, Gloria. This had absolutely nothing to do with the president or his victorious 2016 presidential campaign. It is totally unrelated.
Right. So that's their story, and they're sticking to it. And we should also note, as Caitlin Palance has noted in all her mm-hmm. great reporting this morning, that Donald Trump's name has not come up at all in the courtroom and throughout much of this case. And so they are saying that the White House shouldn't be worried. John Dowd, who used to represent the President of the United States, has always been saying that this case has nothing to do with Donald Trump. So what he is going to cooperate on is going to be pretty interesting.
And clearly that's the whole ballgame there. What is he cooperating on? That's everything. I'm remembering I think it was a tweet. Of course it was, if it came from the president. But on that remarkable day of Manafort being convicted and Michael Cohen being pleading guilty, Gloria, the president at one point tweeted that unlike Michael Cohen, Manafort refused to break, make up stories in order to get a deal. Such respect for a brave man. I now wonder if the president feels that confidence today.
If he thinks Manafort is so brave. I mean, I have a tweet here from back. There's a tweet for everything, as we know. Back on August 22nd, where Donald Trump tweeted that, "I feel very badly for Paul Manafort and his wonderful family. Justice took a 12-year-old tax case, among other things, applied tremendous pressure on him." And it's part of the same quote, I guess, that you're reading. And
exactly.
So I wonder if the president still feels badly. And don't forget, Manafort and the president, during the campaign at least, were not particularly close, according to my sources. Manafort was brought into the campaign by a mutual friend of Manafort and the president's, Tom Barrack. And when stories started being written about his connections with Ukraine and a lobbying for the pro-Russia president, he was dumped unceremoniously from the campaign. So, you know, this is all moving very quickly now, and we're just going to have to let it unspool a little bit to see what it really means.
Let's go over to the White House right now. Jeff Zeleny has some reporting on possibly what the president thinks about all this. Jeff, what are you picking up?
Well, Kate, certainly President Trump is watching all of this unfold, and as Gloria was just saying there, the president certainly made his views clear a month ago after a first proceeding here in Virginia. But the president, I'm told, has been watching all of this unfold this morning on television. He was briefed by his lawyers earlier. He is in the residence of the White House as we speak. The first scheduled item on his agenda was supposed to be a security briefing, an intelligence briefing, but he is focusing on this, at least at the moment. And you saw the statement there from the White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders, again saying this has nothing to do with the president. But of course, that is unclear. And one thing also unclear here is the level of cooperation, as we've been saying. So we certainly know that the president's mood cannot be bright on this. He has always thought that Paul Manafort, even though he has distanced himself from him, saying, oh, we only, you know, worked for me for a brief period of time, they've always thought that Paul Manafort would hold firm. Now, when you add this to the list of others who have pleaded guilty and are cooperating with authorities, certainly it is not something the president was hoping for or expecting. So we'll see if we do hear from the president directly on this. You'll remember after the sentencing of George Papadopoulos just a week or so ago, the president immediately was mocking the 14-day jail sentence, really within minutes of that being announced. He's quiet so far. Of course, not saying much at all today, as he and other members of his administration are overseeing a hurricane coverage. But this is something that certainly I expect would shake him, Kate.
Can I just add one thing about this notion of what is the cooperation?
Yeah.
I mean, what's unclear is what Manafort is saying. The way cooperation agreements work virtually all the time is you have to sit there and answer every single question the prosecutors have. There are not cooperation agreements where you say, well, I'm going to cooperate about X subject but not Y subject. If you are cooperating,
so
you are cooperating.
They're not limiting. The universe of possibility is the universe of possibility, any question that the special counsel would want him to answer.
Absolutely. Now, what is unclear, and I think it's very important to point this out, is whether Paul Manafort has anything incriminating to say about any other person.
Right, but again, would the special counsel, would prosecutors agree to the deal if they didn't think he had anything?
They would agree to the deal if they believed he was telling the truth. And if they believe he's telling the truth and there is nothing incriminating about Donald Trump or anywhere else, I think they would take the deal.
Okay.
Usually they want to build other cases, but I think, you know, the ethical obligation of a prosecutor is to try to get the truth. And if they believe the truth is that he doesn't know about any illegal activity on the part of the president or anyone else, well, then they'll make this deal. What we don't know is what Manafort is saying about other people.
And also, Kate, let me just add, it may not just be about the president of the United States. I mean, if you read through this, and I've just done that, Manafort came up with this entire scheme to hide money so he wouldn't pay taxes on it. And it seems, in fact, that there were both public relations firms and law firms that went along with the scheme, that lobbied members of Congress and others without letting them know that, in fact, this fake entity that they were working for, run by Manafort, was actually being run by the president of Ukraine at the time, the pro-Russian president. And so it's clear to me that Manafort's probably going to be talking a lot about that, too.
There seems to be a lot to talk about now for us and for Paul Manafort. Gloria, thanks so much. Everybody, thank you very much. Again, the breaking news, just to wrap up, Paul Manafort has entered into a plea deal with prosecutors and agreed to cooperate with the special counsel, Robert Mueller, in his investigation. Very important breaking news on the Russia investigation.